Hello and good morning from Seattle. We actually made it here last night. Didn't really get a chance to do a video last night, but we're going to try and do one today and several more, cut them together, put them out. So far, we are joined by several people. For those of you that play FTV mod packs, you might know Dark Osto, who's responsible for Sky Factory. He's here. Hi.
Hey.
There's my back in the mirror. Quetzy got here as well. He's hi.
Hi.
Hi. And then Lynn's still off in bed sleeping. The other person who's here at the moment, Mr. Lex Manos, creator of Forge. Hi. His friend Trotter is out sleeping. I'm not going to do a long video. We can just show you a quick tour of the house here. So I'll switch cameras.
Quetzy's back. I'm back. We're going to do a tour of the house. Let's go outside. Oh, we can't show the address. Actually, the number won't tell us where the address went, will it? It'll only show you a number. It won't...
Show street signs.
Yeah, don't show street signs. So this is the house. Actually, that's their truck. If I do that... Lex is going to the house. It's a big-ass house. There you go. It's Seattle. Let's go inside and have a look around. We got living room, that's all very nice. We've got tables to sit out at the back. I mean, T-Lob is joining us later, isn't he?
Should be.
And maybe a couple other people, surprise guests, we don't know. We have a kitchen. We've got the back. Nice view out the back. Flats. Our bedroom is up in that garage there. We've got a cabin out the back there. And people are still in bed, so we won't do upstairs now. Anyway, that's the Forge house. There you go, whatever. I'm sure we will do that. So yeah, what I'm trying to do today is switch that around. Is that in frame?
That's it, Brian, yeah.
Is it yet?
Yeah.
We'll try and do much shorter clips today rather than the longer ones that we did. There you go. Hi.
I'll be cameraman.
Oh.
That's a bit scary.
Is it? Yeah, we'll do shorter clips today, see if we can keep up with them more often, instead of doing the big long ones that we did yesterday. And we'll cut them through together. I'm going to put this online.
Surely.
Yeah, so you're seeing this within 8 hours of it actually being filmed, I guess, hopefully. Anyway, we'll see you in a bit. Bye.
Bye.
Hello. So, right, what I wanted to do is a public service announcement for British idiots like me. This is an American fridge freezer. We don't see these in the UK because most of our fridges are half this size. But this here is a water dispenser. It doesn't work here, but you push your cup in there and water falls out. The reason I tell you this is because in the UK, what they tend to have in the door is a tank. And you just fill up the tank and the water comes out here. And I kind of assume that that's what this is. And at this point in the video, all the Americans are laughing their heads off because they know exactly what's coming and everybody else probably doesn't. So what I did was I got a bucket of water and I poured it into what I thought was the tank, and then all of a sudden, the floor was a mess. So if you're British and you see a fridge like this, don't put water in here, because this isn't an entrance. This is an exit. This is just ice that goes up here and in there. So yeah, I thought I'd share that with you people.
Meanwhile, no regular viewers are surprised.
Yeah, don't pour ice in holes. Don't pour water in holes unless you know that it's an entrance. There you go. Bye.
So, Banshee's got for the PAX West event. Have you got your badge, Lex? Yay, Dark. And we've got a spare badge, we've got to find a moderator to our panel. Yes. Don't know who that's going to be yet.
Lynn will do it.
Lynn, her moderator. Hi. She's going to be the moderator of the panel now. Maybe.
Yeah,
don't know.
We'll see.
What badges got? We're now going to go to an Apple store because Lex broke his phone.
My phone's converting over.
So we're going to go and buy him. We're going to get him off the evil that is Android.
I'm going to slowly dip my toes into the cult that is Apple.
He's going to buy himself an iPhone. A week before the iPhone 7 comes out, he's going to buy himself an iPhone.
He doesn't give a shit about the 7.
He doesn't give a shit about the 7. So that's where we're going now. And then I'm going to take these guys to a fish market.
Okay.
And we're going to buy food for tonight, aren't we? Okay.
Sounds like fun. Bye. The T-Lom.
What's up? What happened? How was your flight?
It was long, but I got a lot of sleep on that.
Have you been to the house?
Yes.
What do you think?
I am up in the loft, so I'm actually quite pleased with that.
He's up in the loft.
In the single?
Oh, no, you're
in single.
So you're...
Double.
I thought you were a single questioner.
I just know I was one of the doubles, but oh, well, I'll take a single.
That's what happens when you come in late.
Yeah, totally. Like, yeah.
Apparently, the sign-up sheet doesn't matter. It's just first come, first serve. Apparently, I didn't know that. Oh, well.
But we're going for lunch now.
Yes, I'm starving.
Yeah?
Yes.
We are as well.
So hungry.
We're just waiting for Lex. He dropped his phone this morning.
Oh!
Broke it. So he needs a new phone today. Yeah. Can't wait for the new iPhone.
Yeah, I'll wait.
So he's getting a 6S.
My upgrade is coming soon.
And then we're going for lunch. And I'm going for lip balm.
Where are we?
I'm going to go buy lip balm.
This is really good.
That's my wife.
Right. Didn't even like introduce me.
Hello, we're back. We have badges to the Twitch party tonight, which is cool. They hooked us up at the partner lounge. The partner lounge for Twitch is pretty sweet this time. So they got that going on, and then they got a huge area there. Hopefully you can hear me. I should get a lavalier mic for while we're in the halls, really, or something like that. But,
huge dark dinosaur over there.
Yeah, we should go and have a look at that. Where did it go?
It's over there.
Right, yeah, come out and check these guys out. This is kind of insane. Hopefully, again, with the noise, you can hear me, so I'm bringing the phone a bit brighter. But check out this monster here. He is awesome. See if I can get him in frame. We've got this monster right here, and then that guy there, that guy's awesome as well. And then you, kind of cool, big for a lot of people. Anyway, if we see any more interesting, we'll let you guys know. Until then, so we're here in the panel room. It's a big room.
Very big,
but it's in the middle of nowhere, so I don't think we're going to get that many people here.
I think we're going to be probably the emptiest panel that we've done for a while.
The emptiest panel we've ever done.
Yeah,
but that's fine. An intimate setting is sometimes good. But there's the room.
We just need some mood lighting.
They haven't let anybody in yet, so some mood lighting. Yeah. What is it you've got planned?
I don't know. Well, you just said an intimate setting, and we need the mood lighting.
It's not going to be that intimate, I can assure you.
Well,
maybe for you.
It depends. If you sit at the back, it might be.
No. I'm not going to be that intimate with you, sorry.
No, well, we're at the front.
I suppose they could, like, come in here. So, if you fancy a little bit of an intimacy, some privacy, you can jump in the room, go to the back there. It'd be good.
Yeah, just go to the back.
But we'll do another quick vlog after the panel.
Yeah, we might show you how many people that filed in. We'll see.
T-Lob's first time moderating.
Yes, it is my first time moderating. This is going to be a blast.
Do you think?
No.
You haven't got a clue what you're doing, have you?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
So the one thing that we would tell you, make sure everybody gets introduced.
Yes.
Because that's...
We messed that up one time.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
We started the panel with a full hall, and by the end of it...
It was half empty because nobody had a clue who we were.
Testing like we were because we didn't do the introductions. So.
Really?
Yep, yeah. It was great. Anyway, we'll speak to you guys after the panel.
Bye!
Hello!
Hey!
So we've been really bad at this whole vlogging thing, haven't we?
I'm awake now, though.
Are you?
No.
We're getting photobombed.
I'm really not. Yep, birthday boy.
Birthday boy. Happy birthday, dog. Twitch's newest partner on his birthday. And we're in line for the Twitch party.
This is the greatest birthday I've ever had.
Yeah?
Yep. Yep. Thanks for making it so special.
You've never had.
So, panel today was awesome. Went really, really well.
Yeah, because we didn't really do a post-panel.
No, we didn't have a chance to do it. because we got wrapped up by a lot of people outside, want to walk, speak to us. Met with a really, really cool guy who's maybe able to help just general modding out with some stuff in the future. So that'll be awesome.
There's some good contacts out of that panel.
Yeah, there was.
Quite a few good ones.
That alone was definitely worth the trip.
Yeah.
But now we're standing in the queue and we're about to go to...
It's raining too.
Oh, Linda's going to go in the movie. We're about to go to Twitch party.
Yeah, this is the queue for... This is the partner-only queue.
Long-ass queue.
A lot of people here this
long-ass queue. So this should be good.
Yeah, I'm excited. I've never been before.
My first time. Looking forward to it. We will see if we can get this up, and if we meet anybody interesting in the convention, in the party, we'll say hi to them. Let you guys see meet them as well. Well, until then, bye!
I'm sure they will give you a new car.
Look at all these tickets!
Yeah, it looks like you're getting so much credit on it. Where's your car?
Hey, you mind?
Yes.
And
I ran into one of my oldest friends from the community. This is Sam from
approaching
99
Nirvana.
Lives.
Oh!
No! Not Approaching Nirvana anymore.
No, not any longer.
99 Lives, the amazing record label.
True story.
Working wonders for Twitch, guys.
Yes.
Going really well?
It is going very well. We actually launched a 24/7 stream.
Really?
Yep. 24 hour music. You can use it for your stream. But safe.
I'm assuming that Twitch guys can stream from that and...
Yep, it's safe. Safe to use, free to use. In fact, you can go get free music if you just email me, basically.
And what's
the Twitch address? It's twitch.tv/99love.
As in the words?
90, then the number 9, then the word love.
So we put a link for that. 90, the word 9?
Yep.
And then live the word.
Yeah, so 90 the word, 9 the number, live the word.
Okay, cool.
I think we got it.
Yay! So we're just talking about ping pong.
Yeah, so we have a rivalry going.
We do.
And we almost had a $10,000 bet on.
That's true, isn't it?
We were very close to
it. Yeah,
we
were very, very close to that. I'm glad. You may have $10,000, but I don't.
Not anymore. It's all gone to the label.
Yeah, that's great. But anyway, we bumped to Sam. I thought we'd say hi. Hi! Morning, we're in the car traveling because we're craving after the Twitch party from last night.
You need a bag of dicks.
We need dicks. So we've come here and we're going to... I've been told that dicks in Seattle is fantastic. In the morning, so I guess somebody who's rich and famous likes big dicks as well. But yeah, we've come here to see what dicks is like here. So we got our big dicks. It looked nice.
Smells great.
Yeah, it smells wonderful in this.
Yeah.
There's a nice cheesy waft in the air, isn't there? Smells
yeah,
good.
It does. We're definitely looking forward to tucking into some dicks.
Big juicy dicks.
We don't get any dicks found in the UK.
No, it's not a thing.
No, I mean the closest it would be like the
plastic that they sell at McDonald's or something like that.
I don't think that even compares.
No. It was great because we actually saw them cutting the chips fresh. They have a machine and just some guy was, yeah, you could probably see as we go drive past here now. Some guy there, he was just pumping away on the potatoes. Really good wrist action going on there.
I don't think plastic dicks would take anywhere near as satisfying.
So that was Dicks in Seattle. If you come past, I don't know, it's over there. We're on Broadway in East.
There's three locations.
Yeah. Give them a try. Apparently they're great. We're gonna go eat them now, and we'll let you know what they're like.
And this is off the recommendation of our cab driver last.
Yeah, we got a cab driver back, didn't we? And she was a lovely girl. Offered to take us to Dick's.
I got her number for you.
You got her number, did you?
Yeah.
For me.
Yeah.
All right. Are we gonna use her again? Do you think?
Absolutely.
Use an abuser.
Indeed.
Okay. Cool. Yeah, we've started using Lyft more than Uber now.
Yeah, I think mainly because we have free rides to take.
Well, it was also that it's much easier to pick how many seats you want in the car.
Is it?
Yeah, so...
I don't know, I've not actually used Lyft.
Yeah, so Uber, you kind of like, we ordered an XL and they sent us a car that wasn't an XL, was it? It was kind of terrible. And then we went to Lyft and you can pick, say, I want six seats and they send you a six-seater car. So that was great.
Yeah.
And it seems to work a bit.
You can even pick pedal cars.
Yeah.
I didn't notice that on Uber. Pick a pedal car.
I like the fact you can do splits now as well, so you can share the ride and stuff like that.
I think you've always been able to do that.
Not always,
but it's been around for a little while now.
Yeah. Ever since I've been using Uber.
Anyway, right, we will No, I mean like I don't need to split the ride with you. I mean like I could be here and if they've already picked somebody up here, they could come pick me up as well and take the ride and we do the split
ride
there.
Share.
Yeah. Like a ride share, yeah. I think they were doing that. Anyway, we're gonna go and eat our dicks. Bye. So we're back from our dicks.
Mm-hmm.
Did you enjoy your day?
It was very nice.
My dick was good.
I was surprised.
So let's just ask around and Trotter, did you enjoy your dicks?
Most definitely.
Was it good?
Definitely.
So Lex had two big dicks.
They were two big juicy dicks.
And they were nice, weren't
they? They were very nice.
So. Dark had one and a half dicks.
I did. I shared my one of my dicks with Slow.
You did, didn't you?
We shared, yeah. We.
This is never getting old, is it?
Could you not finish the second one?
It's too much. Too much.
You couldn't handle two dicks.
Yeah.
So double penetration, not for you.
Not for
you. Just wanted to touch the sides, and that's it.
Yep.
Okay. It's never getting old. So unfortunately, Lynn didn't have dicks today, did you? Why did you?
Because I'm surrounded by dicks.
So no dicks for Lynn, but me and Quetzy, we had. I one
that
and a half.
That milkshake's really nice.
Yeah, the chocolate milkshake. That. Yum. Dick's chocolate milkshake. Really, 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 really
and
good.
And the chips are good as well.
The chips were hand caught and they were nice.
They were nice, but they were probably be nicer if they were hot.
They would be nice if they were hot.
Yeah.
And it would be nicer if, because Uber Eats is here. Big tip, if you do go for a dick, get a double dick. You don't want one because one dick is not enough. You want two deluxe dicks.
Two deluxe and fries, sure.
Look, this is terrible because like we're all here giving you culinary advice and Dark Osso's like a little child laughing at the word dick. You're like 6 years old. So our culinary advice is double deluxe dips, double deluxe dicks with chocolate milkshakes,
and
hot fries.
Eat
yeah,
hot, definitely.
But really, really good. Anyway, we're going to the panel, aren't we?
You're going to the WOW panel. I'm just gonna.
Yeah, me and Lynn are going to see the WOW Legion panel. Quetzy's going to.
I'm just
going to
cruise the show floor. I think
you're going. You're going cruising.
Not for more dicks.
Quetzy's cruising. Trotter, what are you doing today?
I'm going to go visit my grandma.
Oh,
that's sweet. I don't come up here enough.
So sweet.
Can you?
Lex, what are you doing today?
Running around the show floor.
Running?
Yes.
He runs.
I will thank you.
I want video.
I won't kill you.
The rusty spoon.
You'll be in a dick by now.
And what are you? What have you got on today?
I'm hanging out with Lex until he's done with me and shakes me and throws me out the window.
Are you going to be running with him?
Yeah, we're running together.
Awesome.
We're starting a running team.
Jogging party.
Try and get video
of him. Always want. I want video of Dark and Lex running together around the convention floor.
The problem is that's not allowed to be public.
Right. Okay. We will speak to you guys later.
I'll try to get the video up in a minute.
Yeah. Okay. Bye.
Trying to get you to put it the right way around.
Yeah. Now I have time to put it.
But now
we found the Cards Against Humanity booth.
You dragged me here
to see cards.
To see cards.
It's a store.
You'll see,
it's weird. It's like a maze. Huh?
There's nothing at the end. There's
stairs. There's nothing but stairs at the end. No, they're literally trolling you.
There's also kittens.
There's also kittens.
Kittens?
Let's see where we're going.
Let's go find kittens.
Kittens?
Fun fact. The Lactarius indigo is one of the rarest mushrooms in the world and you could die at any time.
And only what? If you've eaten one, presumably.
Okay, it makes some sense. Applebee's is not good.
I actually like this.
Thank you, Shane. Cards Against Humanity is thrilled to announce that we are sleepy.
See
ya.
Yeah.
The Christian Dad's Vape Summit this way. Let's see what else we've got. The two most perfect words in the English language are edible and arrangement.
No, just edible arrangement.
Okay. By reading this, you're conceding that you're now legally the property of Cards Against Humanity, LLC. Keep going or don't. What can I tell? I can't tell you what to do.
I'm just a sign.
You don't need to start a podcast. Yeah. I read this sign
right now. You should wash your hands.
You don't need to start a podcast.
Oh, but we do.
Oh, I'm blown.
It's PAX 16 and all of us at Cards Against Humanity. Realised we were overdue to thank our fans. Keep going this way for Cards Against Humanity or just give up. Fun fact, Sufjan Stevens is just okay. Fun fact.
Oh.
Who put their face in this hole? And we've got that game.
This is the line for the live kitten room if you want to play with real kitties.
No!
Downstairs
there's real live kitties.
What? Really?
You can play
exploding
with kittens.
Real life kittens.
I'm assuming you want to play with kittens.
Oh, they're real kittens.
I guess so.
Or are they just lying?
They could be lying, you don't know.
Exploding kittens.
Yes. We can come back later and you can play with kitties.
Come us that way.
Right, okay. The bigger, but they sold out.
So we thought we got to the store, and now we're getting trolled with more signs.
I am not convinced that at the end of this there is a store.
That was fun. Let's go check the masks up there.
For the panel?
For the panel.
Yes. All the way.
Ah.
Cards to be made, so
we really do have a store with stock.
Yay!
So we're sat in an airport in
suddenly we're doing a vlog.
We're doing a video log now. We're sat in an airport in Seattle. We've got another how long?
8 hours.
Yeah, okay, we'll sit this way. We've got another 8 hours in this airport. I'm actually gonna upload the log on there. I don't think I'd have the internet here to
do it. I think it'd be struggling.
So I know we said that there's going to be a video log every day, but the person whose only job this weekend was to make sure there was a video log every day,
he's useless, isn't he?
Didn't actually do any work this weekend.
What?
It's not a thing.
Not a thing.
What did you do this weekend of your job? You had one job, which was uploading video logs. What did you do?
I babysat you.
Did you?
Yeah.
You did a good job of that, didn't you?
I did, because you still have the power lead for your laptop.
But I don't have my iPad.
That's your fault.
We missed two flights.
Like, at the point you lost your iPad, it was Lynn's job to babysit you.
Okay. But how many flights have we missed?
Two.
Two. So
who were we waiting for this morning?
Lynn.
Who were we waiting for this morning?
Legitimately. Not me. I was up and dressed and ready to go. Making you a cup of tea.
So was I. I made my own tea this morning.
Did you put your kettle on?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, this doesn't change the fact that we missed the flight.
We did miss the flight. So instead of flying out at 10 a.m. this morning, we're flying out at
9:30 tonight.
Which is actually kind of good because we managed to meet up with Dark Costa.
Yeah, Dark is here. He is actually legitimately flying out at 9 o'clock tonight.
Yeah, I didn't miss my plane.
Yeah. Not yet. He's working on it.
So we spent all morning bitching about Mazda, haven't we? Yeah.
That's every day.
And we had a good night last night.
We did. We went to Bacon Donuts.
We should have. I did suggest at the time that we do a little bit of a vlog spot while we were having the Nerd Fusion tour, but...
Yeah, we went to the Nerd Fusion offices.
Yeah.
They were larger than expected.
It was larger than expected, yeah.
As scruffy as we expected for gamers.
Yeah.
Lots and lots of empty cups.
And...
But it was good.
Yeah.
We actually managed to pick up some advice on some gear. So we're going to look at some new gear for ourselves.
That would be good.
Yeah.
I'll save up some curse points.
Save up some curse points. I don't get any curse points, you know that.
Well, you should write a mod then, shouldn't you?
I am now officially a texture artist. I have textures in an upcoming mod pack.
Yeah. Mod.
Mod, yeah, no, in an upcoming mod, in an upcoming mod pack. Is that fair to say?
That's
totally I am officially a texture artist. Am I getting credits?
You're getting accredited some kind, somewhere.
Somewhere online. So.
Public, maybe.
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 Wow. What can I say?
But the long and the short of it, this is the vlog at the end of our PAX Prime trip, which means... Extreme, is this an extreme close-up? Which basically means that we've had no vlogs while we've been at Prime. So how much have we missed out that we've done?
Like, did we do a recap of the Twitch party or what?
We could do it now. We've got we've got 8 hours to kill.
You can stream it on Periscope too. Stream your whole weekend recap in the next 6 hours.
Yeah.
I don't know if we'd have the bandwidth.
No, it's really bad here. Yeah.
So,
what the Twitch party was. Did we do the Twitch party already?
So, I don't know if we did recap it, but if we didn't, we'll tell you now. The Twitch party was an excellent party, which I'm sure you've seen on
Twitter.
However, we didn't think it was a great...
It wasn't...
Twitch party.
It was a good party and a bad mix-up.
So, for those of you that don't know, as you can see on Dark, he's wearing a... What are you wearing? Do you want to tell us how you got that?
I spent 3.5 hours of my Twitch party playing arcade games, getting 5,100 tickets. So I can buy this sweatshirt.
And then we had to get another 5,100 tickets for...
Look at one here.
So, 2,000 tickets.
Well, we won 12,000.
10,000 plus tickets.
We won 12,000 tickets because we ended up giving Cletho 2,000 towards a blanket that she wanted.
So, in other words, they spent their entire night
pretty much.
Playing silly arcade games.
Yeah, like, until we got hungry.
They had one game where it was like, push a button, and it shoots a missile, and if you manage to hit the middle, you get 50 points.
I mean, it was fun, but it wasn't very good.
But that was 4 hours of their life.
Yeah, that we'll never get back.
No. And they could have spent that time mixing and networking and... But
we could have done, but the thing
is... They saw purple, and that was it. Their lives went.
Well, the thing is, as opposed to, like, the last Twitch party I went to, where they had streamers with purple bands and developers with green bands...
That
was really good, and it meant that you could actually kind of make some connections with different developers, and... Like this party, there was none of that, and that was kind of it shifted from somewhere where business was being done to somewhere that was just fun. So, I don't know whether the mixer at the Twitch call is going to be more of a mixer thing than a party thing.
We did have fun,
yeah.
Me and Lynn went and played WoW Legion, didn't we? You played what did you play? Demon Hunter. We met up with some of the guys from Blizzard, talked to them. So anyway, that was the Twitch party.
Yeah.
The convention.
Convention was... and the panel.
No, we talked about the panel, I'm pretty sure. The panel was good. We met up with guys just in VR and stuff like that. But the convention at home?
It was okay. I mean, it was easier to move around than somewhere like Boston.
Did you see any games you liked?
Did I see any games I liked? Ark actually looked surprisingly good.
Ark does look good, doesn't it?
And there was also Earthfall, I think, which looked quite kind of good. A bit like Killing Floor.
Lynn saw a game that, I can't remember what it was called, Dragon... It was kind of like a PlayStation 4 game that was a cross between Dragon Quest with Minecraft.
I saw that one.
It looked really nice, that.
Yeah.
You picked up on that one. Final Fantasy 15 we saw, we weren't overly impressed.
Not that impressed, no, because...
That just seemed a bit...
When I was chaotic, watching, yeah, when I think it's probably the right word.
The cameras was very close in, it could be a really bad kind of...
You couldn't get an overview of the fight.
Yeah, and then the fights seemed like they were very disjointed. So... and what I mean by that is it's like...
You do your little action
and then it would pause it kind of the old way, or you'd stagger for 10 seconds or something. It didn't feel like it flowed very well.
Yeah, I wasn't too impressed with that.
Pretty though.
Yeah.
Battlefield 1 looked okay.
It looked alright.
Lots of nice VR stuff showing up. I took a quick look at Bridge Crew, Star Trek Bridge Crew. If they can get the multiplayer on that right, that'll be good. If you've got a HTC Vive, that looked okay.
Four or five of them.
You need four. Across the internet works, apparently.
Oh, right.
What we don't know is if it's cross-platform. If it's cross-platform, that'll be awesome. What else did I see that looked good? I don't know.
Loads of board games.
Yeah, I tell you what looked okay, for the Hearthstone fans, the Elder Scrolls clone of Hearthstone looked quite interesting.
Yes, it's a Stoneheart.
I can't remember what it was called. Legends.
No, Stoneheart is... I
think it's Elder Scrolls Legends, I think it's called.
I didn't see that. But Stoneheart is that game that's a mix between Minecraft and Stardew Valley and like a sim game.
Yeah.
Okay.
They had Don't Starve Together was there. Stardew Valley was there. We saw some good stuff from a couple of the hardware manufacturers, Logitech, Intel. But overall, I mean, it was. I'm not a big fan of West because it's all over the city.
It's all spread out.
Spread out.
That was kind of the drawback with the panel as well, because we were, although we had a good time for the panel, we were in a different building completely, so it meant that we were a little difficult to find.
Yeah.
So
we've had 95% confirmation on that subject of Minecon. Our panel will be on Sunday afternoon. Not sure which theatre yet, but it looks like it'll be Sunday afternoon, sort of 2-3 o'clock, I think it is.
I don't know why you're looking at me. This is the first time I'm hearing
No, I'm telling you. I got that through this morning.
Oh, right, okay. Is that why we were late for our plane?
Yeah, that might be why we were late for our plane. Or it could have been that Lynn was still packing her bags, one or the other. Don't hop and call. I'm not. Don't be. No.
You're going to get yourself cut off. I feel like I'm a referee in the middle
I was going to say that happened the day after the wedding, but...
I don't think the wink is going to get you off the hook there.
Did you like that comment? But I won't say that.
As you can see, we're stuck in an airport. We're trying to make the best of it.
We are tired.
We were up super late last night.
It's actually Dark's fault that we were, because we were all ready to go at like midnight.
Midnight.
And Dark kept us there till 3 o'clock in the bloody morning, talking to Bacon about. Can we tell them what we were talking about? I guess we were talking about Sky Factory 3.0.
The next mod pack.
We have some big plans, don't we? None of which will actually come to fruition in true FTB style.
Well, you hope that they do.
We'll see.
So we'll see. But yeah, that was. It was a good night last night.
Yeah, it was worth going out.
Yeah.
Even though I was falling asleep standing up.
But we're going to spend the next. What are we at?
8 hours.
8 hours.
I don't know. I went to look at the time, but my watch is just telling me to stand up.
Okay. We're going to spend the next 8 hours doing nothing, pretty much.
Actually, 7 hours at this point.
We'll get some cards. What time is it now?
It's 2 o'clock.
Yeah, we'll walk down there at 7. So what time is it now?
2.
3, 4, 5, 6. So it's only 5 hours.
Only 5 hours, yeah.
Yeah, it's not bad. We've passed 5 of them already.
Yeah.
We should be landing now.
No, we would have landed about an hour ago.
Oh, would we?
Yeah. I didn't want to say anything because
she's already, Lynn
already
anyway,
has
so.
The daggers out.
Yeah. She's already going to kill me anyway, so.
And if I told her that, then she would have made it through you and probably stabbed me as well.
At least we wouldn't have to wait the next 5 hours.
Getting painted as a terrible person.
I thought you were going to say terrorist then.
It's only because of the looks you're giving right now.
They are kind of evil, aren't they?
They are.
This is what they have to look
with. Looks those. Could kill.
Do you want to see her look?
No. Have you noticed though I'm nice to everybody else?
Except me.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. The one person she's married to is the one person she hates. Now you know.
Can you see what I have to put up with over the next 3 weeks?
You lucky, lucky guy. You could be back at home in England.
I could be.
Anyway, right, I'm gonna, because this is already 13 minutes.
It is. That's good, because it's like we haven't done anything for like 4 days. So this is 4 days worth of work.
Content.
13 minutes long, only one of them is talking about the convention. The next 12 is picking
up
me.
No.
Yes.
All right, so we'll talk more about the convention. We'll talk more about the convention then. Did you see any good cosplay?
The cosplay was... I'm not going to give my comments on the cosplay.
Okay.
There were some decent ones.
It's a good Overwatch. It's great Overwatch cosplays.
I don't know.
I wonder why you enjoyed the Overwatch cosplays.
They were wonderful.
Were they?
It was a very enriching experience.
Is that what I call it these days?
That's what I'm calling it.
Something. Overwatch, if nothing else that it's done for our community, it's given us good cosplay.
There you go.
Is that what we're saying? No matter how good or bad the game
that's
is.
That's what he's saying.
I'm actually convinced, thinking about it, that Blizzard intentionally give their female characters fairly revealing, shall we say, costumes just for the cosplayers.
What, because if they weren't revealing, the cosplayers wouldn't cosplay them?
Well, no, because it allows them to be revealing, which lets all the Blizzard employees that are at the conventions
what you think?
Take a peek. It's basically, so what we've determined is Blizzard employees are perverts. And they design characters in not a lot of gear in order to have a peep show.
I'd like to be edited out of this video. Nothing to do with any of this, these statements. I'm fine with Overwatch.
So yeah, Dark Horse, though, that's your belief, is it?
I like Overwatch, it's a wonderful
You
game.
Are the
Everybody
one who brought
Blizzard
up the cosplay.
Absolutely wonderful. I don't have any issues. It's a great game.
There you go, that's his official spin. Is that what we call that?
I think that's what we call backtracking.
Backpedaling. That was a serious backpedal, wasn't it? When he realised exactly what it was he was referring to. Or inferring. Right, anyway, we're going to go.
Yep. I'm sure there'll be another one later on when we finally catch up, like.
Maybe. That was it. It's not like you're going to do any work this week, is it?
I don't know.
Maybe.
Actually, I've already been working this morning. I had to reset servers last night.
Oh, that's true, actually. Yeah.
So, yeah. There's not a lot I can do because I've only got a phone.
We're trying out a new mod. It's not working very well, is it? An old mod for a new pack, or...?
There's a couple of mods that are basically causing problems in one set.
And fireworks?
Yeah, that mod, I think, just needs to go. That needs to go die in a fire.
Right.
Not in a firework, but in a fire.
Anyway, I'm done.
Yeah, see you later.